I have the eye condition known as retinitis pigmentosa. Over the years, friends, family, and even strangers have asked me to describe exactly what I see and what I don't. The concept of partially sighted or mostly blind is not an easy thing to understand. Some people think either you see or you don't, as if there's no in-between. But, like any other affliction, there are many stages. And this is only an explanation of my symptoms. First, a quick and not too scientific explanation about human eyesight. Normally, a person sees about 180 degrees all around, which means you can't see behind you, but you are pretty much aware of everything to the left and to the right and up and down, even if you are looking straight ahead. That is until something goes wrong, like, say, macular degeneration, which kills your central vision along with small details and color perception, or retinitis pigmentosa, which kills your peripheral vision and dim light perception. Let me explain. If a person with macular degeneration tries to read a book with no central vision, a frustrating, blurry mess of an image occurs. In retinitis pigmentosa, the peripheral or side vision is destroyed first, and only viewing something with adequate lighting sends a narrow but clear image to the brain. Forget about seeing anything that is not brightly lit. So, what do I see now? Some doctors call RP sight tunnel vision and describe it like a hole in which we view the world. Not really. The brain does a wonderful thing. It fools me into thinking I still see everything. Here's my lovely wife, Marcia Grossman, back in 1978, before she became a dentist on New York's Upper West Side. She is seen here contemplating the next 4 years of dental school. When I entered the room, I saw only parts of the whole scene and was not aware of the objects in the periphery until I scanned around the room. Rather than being in a dark tunnel, I am in a haze of phantom peripheral images, and the only true image is the one that I am directly looking at. My brain is busy making up the rest. I am not even aware of it, much like a normal-sighted person is not aware of their less detailed peripheral vision. So, we with RP go through the day mostly unperturbed by the missing field of vision until an unseen object, like an open door, a wall, a chair, an iceberg, comes out of nowhere and makes its presence known. And at nightfall, when mostly everything not lit up disappears, we remember again how much vision we lost. This can go on for decades, depending on which version of RP you have, and there are many. Eventually, in my case, the cone cells in the macula die as well, and images go blurry, disappear, and distort. Though, when I shift my eyes around, the missing parts come back into view and other areas start disappearing. Constantly scanning a page is the only way to see it. This makes reading very slow as letters play hide and seek with me. One more thing. My friend Jackie here no longer looks like this to me. Since I am losing my central vision cone cells rapidly, my acuity is going downhill fast. Probably because there are less cells sending the information to my brain. Kinda like having a low resolution 1 megapixel retina instead of a 14 megapixel one like you probably have. There are also other visual phenomena, like brilliant flashes of white sparks during periods of exertion, colored blobs of light, bleached out white areas, floaters, which are dead cells drifting by, and an ever-present dim spiderweb-like vessel pattern. But at the moment, I am glad that I still see anything. I hope you now understand what partially sighted means. If you'd like more information, visit the Foundation Fighting Blindness website at fightblindness.org. And if you donate, tell them Steve on Team iPod, that's E-Y-E-P-O-D, sent you. This video is for educational purposes only and is not meant as medical advice. See your healthcare practitioner for any questions you may have. The Foundation Fighting Blindness has no involvement or affiliation in the making of this video. I just like that foundation.